Hi, my name is Zico. I'm a technical specialist at Pico Technology. Welcome to our Getting Started with a new PicoLog 6 software. In this video, we'll demonstrate how quick and straightforward it is to use the new PicoLog 6 software. To all our new PicoLog data logger owners, congratulations on your new purchase. To our existing PicoLog owners, you're in for a treat with a new software. And don't worry if you don't have a device, because you can run it in demo mode. So let's get started. So we'll start off by loading the software with no unit plugged in to demonstrate how you can get demo devices working. When the software starts, you're prompted with enable a demo device. Click on that. And in this case, we'll choose a TC08. So if we select one demo device, and then go back to the device views, you can see a TC08 image appearing on the screen. For the purpose of this video, we'll be using a real USB TC08 plugged in. So this is the kind of thing you get with your new PicoLog data logger. So if we open it up, you'll get the USB data logger installation guide, a USB cable, and your device. In this case, it's the USB TC08. So if we plug the unit in, and then plug in it over there, the software will scan for the new unit, and in this case you'll see the device with the serial number A0043/525. So if we flip the unit, you may be able to see the serial number there. So now what we'll do is we'll remove the demo device, and we can do this by accessing the menu bar on the left and clicking on the settings view. And if we go to demo devices, and I change one demo device to none, and then go back on the left hand side and then click on the device settings view, which brings us back to the main screen. And as you can see, we have the USB TC08 plugged in. For the purpose of this video, we're using two K-type thermocouples on channel 1 and channel 2. We can now add them. You can do this by simply clicking on the image and on the channel that you require. So channel 1, we'll click on that. We can change the channel name, but we'll leave it as default. We can also change the color of the channel. So if we click on that, we'll leave that as default as well. We can also change the sampling interval. This can be milliseconds, seconds, or minutes. And you can also choose your thermocouple type. In this case, we're using a K-type thermocouple. Then you simply click on Add Channel. We'll do the same for channel 2, leave everything else as default, and then click on Add Channel. You can now see the channels appearing on the right hand side, giving us live readings. We can now start recording by clicking on the record button. You can see it flashing there, indicating that it's starting to capture data. On the left hand side, you can see the device settings, which displays all the units that are connected to your computer. Then we have the capture graph view. This will display your graph, and in here we can start to look at some of the basic controls. So we can choose the zooming functions. So we can zoom in, we can zoom out, we can have a zoom selection, we can also undo, and we can pan. We can now go through the rest of the menus on the left-hand side. The next menu is the Saved File Manager. If we click on that, that will show us all our previously saved data files. Then we have our software settings. We have our regional and language settings. You can change your language, your temperature units, and so on. The file handling, this is your file location. How you want the device to behave in power saving modes. The demo devices, if you wanted to add a demo device, updates and privacy settings, and resetting settings and loading factory default. Thank you for watching, and for more information, please visit www.picotech.com.